Hey, Chris, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. This week, CVS Caremark, the drugstore chain that competes directly with Walgreens, announced it will stop selling cigarettes and other tobacco products at its stores by October 1st this year. CVS has taken the position that the sale of tobacco products is inconsistent with their purpose, which is now defined as helping people on their path to better health. CVS will lose approximately $2 billion in annual sales from tobacco shoppers as a result of this decision. What has CVS received for the promise of not selling cigarettes? An endorsement from the president himself. President Obama said, "As one of the largest retailers and pharmacies in America, CVS Caremark sets a powerful example, and today's decision will help advance my administration's efforts to reduce tobacco-related deaths, cancer, and heart disease, as well as bring down healthcare costs, ultimately saving lives and protecting untold numbers of families from the pain and heartbreak for years to come." On top of a presidential endorsement, which is the equivalent of an infomercial, due to the massive number of news outlets picking up the story and commenting on it, even here on Goldseek, it may well be a good long-term investment for CVS. Whether or not CVS follows through with eliminating tobacco products, they have bought 8 months of free advertising that is news and event-driven. Smart marketing, no matter how you slice it. I have no issue with CVS voluntarily dropping the sale of tobacco products. However, I suspect and fear this massive ad campaign about not selling tobacco products will be used to coercively dictate to other firms that they too should stop the sale of tobacco products. That somehow this PR campaign will be used to inspire already pre-planned legislation. It's just how the game is played. If cigarettes are so heinous, why don't we just ban them outright? I'll tell you why. Revenue. If cigarette sales for one retailer total $2 billion, they represent massive revenue streams for all other retailers as well. And, in particular, the government, through taxation. Cigarettes are tax-collecting mechanisms. They will never be banned. Just demonized and taxed. Just like big oil and gasoline for your car. These industries are demonized and taxed. A huge percentage of every gallon of gas for your car is really made up of federal and state taxes. Every time this kind of rhetoric surfaces, be suspicious. It's not about a healthier America. If it were, our commander-in-chief would kick his chain-smoking habit and set an example for the country. But he won't. And I would suggest that the possibility exists that CVS may not completely rid themselves of tobacco products either. There's still a lot of time between now and October 1st to make adjustments to this policy announcement. In the meantime, there's a lot of free publicity to garner. Chris, on February 21st and 2nd, I'll be speaking at the 2nd Annual Liberty Mastermind Symposium in Las Vegas with 15 speakers, 3 panel discussions on one amazing day. Details are on my website, and until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. reminding you to follow us on Twitter @ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.